See now that I, even I, am he, and there is no Elohim with me. I kill and I make alive. I wound and I heal. Neither is there any that can deliver out of my hand. For I lift up my hand to heaven and say, I live forever. If I wet my glittering sword and my hand to take hold on judgment, I will render vengeance to mine enemies, and I will reward them that hate me. Skip down to 43. Rejoice, O ye nations, with his people, for he will avenge the blood of his servants, and I will render vengeance to his adversaries, and will be merciful unto his land and to his people.
Hey, let's get the Wisdom of Solomon, third chapter. Start reading that verse one. In the Apocrypha, those that don't understand what the Wisdom of Solomon is.
Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 3.
So this is why I want to say this before we start reading. This is why I'm really not mourning. My beliefs, and I'm really sincere about my beliefs. So when I read the scriptures and I get a particular understanding, I believe that this is real. I know where we are right here. When you lose your life, or you end your life, that's not the end. That's only the beginning of the real life. Does that mean we should go and take our lives and rush it? No. Most High put you here for a reason. The precept that Yashabim just read, it basically tells you that nothing can happen unless the Most High allowed that thing. Nothing can happen. The reason that he was able to go and pretty much he blew his brains out, his own brains, to do that is because the Most High allowed that thing. If we clearly want to understand and overstand and understand things, we have to always ask why. If you really want to understand how things work, you have to understand why. You got to ask yourself the question, why? And to those of you who are unaware, Kahan Tal Gadol has a new book coming out, probably within, over the next week or so. That book's title is Why Am I Here? Why am I here? And I thought it imperative to ask this question, because when you ask the typical man or woman why they really here, the answer is generally they don't know. You know, I never really thought about that. So I'm going to tell you, you have to be able to ask, to answer that question, why are you here? So I want everyone to muse over that. And think about why you really here. Why are you here? If you can't answer that question, then you're in trouble. Because if you don't know why you're here, then you don't have a purpose, and you're not working on your purpose. If you can't answer that question, you may not love you enough. And anyone that doesn't love himself, I will never trust that person to tell me that they love me. Because all love begins with self-love. Everything that I experience in my life is for a reason and a season. And I surmise that this was to make me wiser, help me understand, and maybe wake up some of the masses and some of the people that was really close-knit to the brother Barak Shah. That we're not promised tomorrow. I say that consistently, and people take it as something trivial until it hits home. It was never important. I've been saying it all along, but no one really, really considers that how valuable the gift of life really is until it affects them it affects one of their loved ones, then it's mourning and weeping, and then everything's going back to normal. Goes back to normal, and you return to your sins, you return to the world that you was once living in. But I would highly suggest that you really, really muse over this thing. Stop taking life for granted. Because we're not just saying you're not promised tomorrow. This is a fact. You also be let's get that precept. Jadir, I still didn't get yours. I just seen Kadar's pop up. Looks like the spam, but I'm not sure. Give it.
All right. Wisdom of Solomon, chapter 3. But the souls of the righteous are in the hand of the Supreme Allahan, and there shall no torment touch them.
Okay, so the scriptures say the souls. What is your soul? It's a nefesh. The Hebrew word for soul is nefesh. So people are mourning and weeping when someone passes and when someone dies. But the scripture said that the soul of the righteous man, the righteous woman, is in the hands of Yahuwah. And no torment shall touch them. I don't know about you guys, man. I face torment in this world each and every day. But I still am in no rush to cross over and get to the other side and go into the spiritual world. Because I haven't been there. I can't say what's there for sure. My method of measurement of the spiritual realm is the Bible. What do you use? God, read on, huh?
Verse 2. In the sight of the unwise, they seem to die.
See, in the sight of the unwise, so-and-so's dead. No, he just changed his form. You see, this is what you guys have to all accept. Dying is a part of life. That's a part of life that no one wants to face until it hits. And then it's often too late, so you're not prepared. This is why when some people die, some people just lose it. They think about committing suicide. They think about hurting themselves. It's a part of life. I love the brother. Try to instill as much hope and faith into the brother that I could. I wasn't able to reach that one as I thought I did. Because in order to hurt yourself, to kill yourself, you are suffering from self-loathing. I said that to the brother. I might have hurted him, but he needed to hear it. Because he had this thing with Edomite women. And I told him that's from self-loathing, brother. You don't love yourself enough. So you're trying to find it somewhere else. How can you love me? How can someone love me that they don't, if you don't love yourself? In that moment, I asked Jadir, I asked Kadar. You was there, this man trying to harm himself. Do you think that this man would have possibly harmed you if you try to step him? It seems like he had a death wish. It said the neighbor came to try and step him, stop him. And he said, yeah, listen, man, you better get out of my way or I'm going to shoot you. This had to be demons whispering to him.
Huh.
Damn sure wasn't angels. Angels don't tell you to do bring harm upon yourself. That was one of Satan's agents. So where did the soul go? Go ahead, read on up.
And their departure is taken from misery.
So people cry, people mourn, people want to hurt themselves because they really don't understand this book like they proclaim to. Because when you die, the departure is taken from misery. Most I built me for this kind of thing, man. If that's what the how Shaitan is trying to use to bring Tyler the Doc down, you're gonna have to bring a lot more than that, huh? I've been growing up around death since I was a boy, man. People around me has always died, man. It's nice, I'm still standing. I fell down for a minute. I got back up. I need everyone in the sounds of my voice to comprehend that Barack Shah didn't have any challenges that none of us hasn't faced. See, when people face these things alone, and when you isolate yourself like an island, you like to tell yourself, you don't understand, brother. Yeah, I do understand, man. What you don't understand, or what you should have understand, is you should have brought your ass and talked to one of us. And I'm not going to mourn you until I join you, because my life is going to go on. That was your choice. You made a choice. I can't suffer because of that. And one half, it was a selfish decision to take his life, because it was a form of cowardice and it was a heroic act. It was two people. It was like him battling against his altered ego. And I've always told you people, listen, man, your enemy is your enemy. That's your greatest enemy that you're going to have to face. And he was not capable of overcoming his inner me, his inner self, his greatest enemy, and it ended up destroying it. I don't just say things for conjecture, man. I say what the spirit put on me. Your inner me is your enemy. That's your greatest enemy that you're gonna have to fight. Because you're gonna have a problem with your external forces if you got a problem with yourself. Have a tendency to look at everything from a negative perspective. The glass was always half full for me, but the glass honestly was always half empty for the brother. I would say, brother, why you gotta look at it so negatively, subjectively? What about objectively? Made his choice. He said, I'm just not strong enough. Did it mean he wasn't strong enough? No, I mean, he took the easy way out. Took the easy way out. And in doing so, I contend, and I'm entitled to my own personal opinion, his motive was to hurt other people, to get that woman's attention, and to show his daughter, okay, you guys don't care about me, I'll show you. But guess what? Who won? They won. Because you can't come back from that. You can't come back from that. Soul fell, where did it go? Most High only knows. Go ahead, read,
Verse 3. And they're going from us to be utter destruction, but they are in peace.
See, you know, I hear the brother Dwayne said last night, suicide is unforgivable. Oh, that's Christianity. I still challenge anyone to show me anywhere in the Bible where it says suicide is an unforgivable act. The unforgivable sin is blasphemy. Doesn't make it right. But it doesn't say it's unforgivable. Now, if we think of it from perspective, he committed that sin and he can't ask for forgiveness in this physical realm. Most High is going to have to sort that out. But I have to keep living, man, because both Yahuwah and HaShaitan is not finished with me yet. You see, while Yahuwah is voting for me, HaShaitan is constantly placing barriers in my way, your way, Yaqubin's way, Kadar's way, everyone's way, man. The question is, will you yield to it? Will you give in? So you're not built for this. Fair enough.
Verse 4. For though they be punished in the sight of men, yet is their hope full of immortality.
Okay. Your Jardier, I still never got your email. You might want to send that again. I think it would have came through by now.
Haven't been a little chastised.
So what was he going through? Think about it. Since he came here, the man has stopped using, smoking so-called, you know, weed, getting high. He had quit cigarettes and all that. He was getting strength. See, someone give me the precept where it says to see the end from the beginning. See, that brother couldn't see that. He was too focused on the current thing to have any kind of vision. But to have vision, man, you have to have a target. If I'm a marksman, I need a target to aim at, or otherwise I'm gonna lose my focus and my skills. And if there's no target, there's nothing to aim at. So I gotta have a target. And with that target, I have to focus on that target. But if I don't have no target, then I don't have any goal and I won't accomplish nothing and I'm not going anyway. You gotta have something to aim at. That's your why. So everybody in the sounds of my voice, what is your why? Because if you don't have one, you're gonna feel worthless, man. And I don't want anyone else, man, around me, man, fall within that paradigm. I just got another disturbing call this morning. Brother that I've been knowing since 2012, Tyler Dock, I'm on my dying bed. Nobody wanted to talk to the brother. He called me early in the morning. I already knew. I haven't heard from the brother, but he never calls me at this time, early in the morning. Dying bed, I almost died. Voice sounds weak. Got some sort of bacterial poison in his blood. Said he called his so-called best friend, who's supposed to be a priest, and he told him, Most High told me to tell you, man, that he's very upset with you. How is that Christ-like? This man's on his deathbed. This man, he called you because he believes in you, brother. He confided in you. You tell the man, the Most High told me to tell you, he's very angry with you. I said, man, don't listen to that, man. That man got a damn demon on him, man. Ain't no man of the Most High is going to tell you that. And when you're on your, you know what I mean? This man is in a hospital bed with tubes. You know what I mean? He put a suction thing to his chest because that was blockage in his chest area. So he got to the point, he managed to drive himself back to the hospital. He couldn't move. He said, y'all got to come and get me now. I'm going to die right here. Outside in the hospital parking lot, he couldn't walk. Had to come and get him. He didn't turn around. He said, they told him today, if you didn't turn around and drive back to the hospital, you would have died. He said, what? It was another challenge. I can't say that. Bad news is just a challenge. So, brother, you're going to be all right. Not for Tally start putting some speaking life into it.
Dang.
Lit up when Nefertali started talking to him, man. Praise be the Most High, man. For Nefertali. That brother have a way with words, man. Nefertali was speaking life into him. The brother was talking low and weak. When Nefertali started speaking, he said, I appreciate that, but it kept getting shrunk. He said, praise the Most High. Speaking life into him, huh?
God.
Then the nurse came in the room. He said, I'll call you brothers back. We right here, brother. We're not going anywhere.
That's right.
We're not going to kick you when you're down. Come on. The call back. About 40 minutes later, we still on the call. Talk to him again.
God.
Nurse comes in the room again. Call your brother back. Call back. About 45 minutes later, we're still on the call.
God.
He said a doctor's call coming in the room, man. I'll call you back. I haven't heard back from him right now, man. Praise be the Most High, man.
Praise be the Most High, King.
You got to know someone's there for you, man.
Come on.
Because, I mean, if you don't know, you don't think you got no one, man, you done lost all hope. But guess who's behind this? So now you men will understand why I'm always talking about every man in this world should join MAF. Hashtag MAF. Men Against Feminism and hashtag WAF. Women Against Feminism. Hashtag MAF, hashtag WAF. Because behind these two brothers, there's a woman involved. There's a woman. And both of these women has had their children snatched away from them because a woman is being vindictive. Don't you know this brother Nefertali couldn't even show up at the Passover? Because when he's trying to go to the Passover, the same brother, the same so-called priest called Yochanan, the brother told him, I want to come to the Passover. But the woman went there out of spite. She's not even in the truth. So that brother couldn't come because she have a restraining order against this brother, man. She got a revenge on him against herself and against his own child.
Damn.
That's bringing all kind of pressure on this man. You see what I'm saying? Yeah. Same thing Barack Shaw was dealing with. He couldn't handle it. He checked out. And all of these things happen. You know, and there's a chronological order. He goes to court. He's fighting for it. He's trying to see it. Now, you see how these damn women be saying, oh, yeah, deadbeat dads? Now, here's a brother that's fighting hard body in court for his daughter, man, to spend more time with her to try and get 50-50, and the mother's bringing a foreign man around. Man giving fake names in courts and all of this, and she's with him. And got this man around his daughter. She don't know nothing about the man, but he's using a fake name, that's for sure. So, he calls a week ago and says he's highly depressed. It took more time away from him. Mm-hmm. Brother, I said, listen, brother, you got to stop allowing this to get to you like this. Yeah, I can hear it in your voice. You're going into depression, man. You got to man up. This too shall pass. But I have to realize everyone's not built like me. This is a wake-up call when I hear brothers talk. I have to really listen to what they're saying, because I'm, you know, I'm presuming that men are supposed to be strong like me. You see what I'm saying? You bring anything at me, man, I'm going to get back up unless you kill me, man. But I'm damn sure not killing myself. I want to get back up, because that's what's in me, man. I got to realize that a lot of men are not built like that. So that broke his spirit. And then this week, his daughter was supposed to come over. You guys seen her on the call? Brother seemed depressed. Nah, she didn't come over. She decided to go with her stepdad. Crushed it. Crushed his spirit. This woman knows that she's in the background. She's telling the girl all these things. The girl's coming saying things to him. Then his own daughter betrays him by taking his business cards and taking them to the mom so they could garnish his wages. The straw that broke the camel's back was where he went to the ATM machine Thursday morning to extract cash. He got a negative balance of over $400,000. I said, brother, that's not legal. They can't overdraw your account like that. They might be able to put a lien or something. I said, I thought you'd done the notice of lien. I did it. But after listening to the brother, he didn't do it correctly. So now I'm chastising him for that. You gotta fix it up. And it's like he was there, but he wasn't there, asking me the same questions over and over. Ah, I just said that to you, man. You gotta pull yourself together, man. All right, I'm gonna go down there and fix it now. Bro was already planning suicide. He can share this with me. He sent messages out to Kadar, Jaikid. And his message, there was really suicidal message, text. If you look at it now, hindsight's always 20/20. But then it's like, oh yeah, he's just, you know, going through it. Never thought the brother would harm himself. You just never know where people are mentally. This is what I'm telling everyone, man. Under the sounds of my voice, like I said last night, man, if you're going through something and feel like you just can't handle it, give me a call, man. I was at the hour. Give a call. So behind both of these brothers is a woman. Is a wicked woman. That's plotting, that's scheming, that's ripping these men, children away out of their lives. And they say, he's a man, he can take it. Breaking a man down, make the man feel hopeless, like he has nothing. And the system needs to be fixed, man. And so I'm telling you, man, as long as you sit around and complain, do nothing, it's gonna continue this way. No one is coming to save you. So no one is coming to save you. Save yourself, man. The woman, she's, from my opinion, and I'm entitled to my opinion, she contributed to his destruction. She aided to the stress. That, I mean, he would get extremely emotional talking to her. And she pushed for him to be incarcerated. It was only $2,000 per month. They ripped that out of his account. I thought he should have been okay. But I guess when he felt like he didn't have that money to go to work, that was the store that did it. Then he started sending these crazy text messages. That's he. Oh man, if I don't be here on the other side, this brother's speaking death. He's not talking life. He sent that to me. I would have called him and said, listen, man, tighten your ass up, man. This is life. It's called life, man. You don't have anything any more difficult than what I've been through. It's life. Play the hand that you was dealt, man. Stop bitching about it. You don't like the hand, man. You keep playing until your hand improves. That's how you play the game of life. Nobody's gonna come and save you, man. Because people really don't care. Deodato, George Appen, talk of intent. But when it comes down to it, who really cares? Selective few. Anyway, that's why everybody in this world gotta have at least one person. At least one person to care about you, because no man was created to be an island. This is why the Most High said it's not good for man to dwell alone, man. You can't dwell alone, man. You're not gonna make it. He was not designed that way. Create a new man for him is a help me. Not a smart mouth. Not a snake. Not a masculine, combative, demonic entity. A help for him. So they wanted to humble themselves, man. Come back. It's a womanhood. Been a doom. So this is why I speak like I speak about women. Because a lot of women out here, man, they're feminists. Keep allowing this to happen. They'll destroy you. And no mistake about it. Destroy you. Finish that precept, Yashabi.
Verse 5. And having been a little chastised, they shall be greatly rewarded. For Supreme Elohim proved them and found them worthy of himself. That's the end of verse 5.
Huh. Someone get Romans 14, verse 8.
Huh. I got the other one from Isaiah, the... beginning from the end.
Yeah, God.
Con, the book of Yeshaya, Isaiah chapter 46, verse 9. Remember the former things of old, for I am the Supreme Elohim, and there is none else. I am the Supreme Elohim, and there is none like me, declaring the end from the beginning, and from ancient times, the things that are not yet done, saying, my counsel shall stand, and I will do all my pleasure.
Just got a message from JD saying his condolence. One of the Lord's best friends. I got it this time, JD.
Come on. The book of Romans, chapter 14, verse 8. For both, if we live, we live to the Master. And if we die, we die to the Master. Therefore, whether we live or die, we are the Master's. For to this Mashiach died and rose and lived again, to rule over both the dead and the living.
Why, I can't answer why someone choose that, but to me, it's a cop-out, man. If you know, if you like that, if you're in that condition, speak up, man. Speak up. You need help. Speak up. You contemplating any kind of suicide or thought, man? Speak up.
Come on.
Because you can't come back from that. No coming back from that.
Nope.
If you're trying to do that, you think you're doing that, and you're doing that to teach a woman, then you're very wrong. You're very, very wrong. You're not coming back from that. That's final. That's final, man. You're not coming back from that, ever. You know, people could talk and so on and so forth, but none of us know what's on the other side, man, until we get there. I can tell you, it's not over after this. You gotta be crazy to believe that everything ends. It is, man. But none of us should be in a rush to get there. Well, you just, you know, this brother, he done something that he brought affliction on a lot of people around him, with that move. With that move, man. I mean, this man, you know, you're talking to a man. He basically did this right after he got off the phone with myself and Kadar. Besides that, neighbor, you know, and maybe, I don't know if he went and talked to his mom. We was pretty much the last voices that this man heard. You know what I mean? And this man had this in his mind. He knew what he was going to do, Kadar. When he hung up the phone, he knew he wasn't going to the bank. We're thinking he's at the bank and he doesn't show up on the call. Oh, man. What's going on? Brother not answering the calls. Brother's not on the live stream. Unusual. Unlike him. Something's up. I thought he was locked up. Like I said, even if he was, he still probably would have tried that in there, man. Let's get John 11 and 26. John 11 and 26. Y'all can know.
Come on. The book of John, y'all can know. Chapter 11, verse 6. Therefore, when he heard that he was sick, then indeed he stayed at the place where he was 2 more days. Then after this, he said to the pupils, let us go back to Yahuwah. The Talmudim.
Salaki, y'all. He said verse 26.
11 and 26?
Verse 26. Salaki. Verse 26. And everyone that is living and believing in me shall never die at all. Do you believe this?
You see that? See that? This is what all of you have to ask yourself, man. I've always said, times of peace prepare for war because peace doesn't last forever. The most difficult battle you will ever fight is your number one foe, which is the Satan of self. Your inner me is your enemy. If you do not overcome this Satan of self, it may lead you to suicidal thoughts. So you better overcome that thing, man. See, and this is the other thing. You gotta love yourself. You know, I'm gonna say to you, man, because I get all kind of hate mail and all of that, but I'm still be me. I still stand up and I do me, man. See, I don't need you to love me. Talking to anyone out there that has any kind of dislike to me, man. I'm not Barack Shaw, right? Children, whoever, man. I don't need you to love me. Because I love me before any external source loved me or claimed to love me. You understand what I'm saying? So you loving me is just extra. Because I'm already loved. You see what I'm saying? I got self-love. I don't need you to love me. I mean, it's good. It's a bonus. Power just split. Luckily, I have the backup battery there. Just lost the connection. But that's a bonus. When a third party loves me. Right? It's extra. Their likes are good. Their love's good. But it's not required. This is how we gotta think. You gotta never get in I need you guys to listen to me, man. Never get in a situation that you can't walk away from. That you get so caught up into that situation where the man's in love so much he can't walk away from that. The world wants you to believe that. This stuff you've seen on TV, man, will destroy you. It's not real. Got men bowing down to women, getting on one knees, asking for... Listen, man, that's not manhood. That's emasculation. No one could jump for me. No one can experience my fall. And if I fall, I must stand back up again. Those that say, I say to all of you, those that say that they're on your team, right? You must examine how they contribute to your life. How they contributing to your life, Nefertali? They say they're on your team, how they contributing to your life? Justice? They say they're on your team. Because if it's not positive, I'm gonna hit you with something. Maybe it's time for you to get some more teammates. You could take that as something trivial if you want it, but you better heed the knowledge.
Calm.
I'm going to tell you all like I told Barack Sean, man. Everything you need to get back up is already within yourself.
Calm.
Know what I told you? Everything you need to get back up. I told that man that, man. Man, that ain't where I should be. Listen, man. I don't want to hear your sob stories, man. Everything you need to get back up, it's already within yourself. Man, you haven't been through nothing that I haven't been through. You just don't want it bad enough. I wanted it more than you. But you now, nah, man, this dude trying to make me out to be something special. I said, man, don't try. That's an excuse, man, for your failure. I'm just more driven, man, that's all. See, because the Most High instilled talent and greatness in all of us. You know what I told you, Nefertali? All of us has that, man. Some of us are too damn lazy to get up. And when it get difficult, we break the hell down. We back away from the struggle. Because the human mind doesn't like struggle, man. The human mind, this is why people leave relationships. When it gets difficult, they leave. They don't want struggle. That's how you refine gold, man. That's to go through the struggle. These people are not positive teammates. You might need a new team. Some people like to say, man, you're extremely gifted. You know why? Because this enables them to create excuses for their failure. They could justify their failures now. But you know what the beauty of my success, Nefertali, is? Is that I came from the bottom. I came from the bottom. Nigga, you ain't shit. Nigga, you ain't gonna make it. You gonna be dead or in jail by the time you're 25. Giggle, giggle. I'm still standing. Okay. Giggle, giggle. I'm still standing. How about that?
Okay.
A dude, like I was telling you guys on the call, the dude, he was watching me on YouTube. He said, man, this MF is gonna go to jail. He can get locked up. Or he can get killed. The dude, he said he came back 6 years later. And he said, man, I had to call this MF for coaching, man. Cause then he got on the call. He said, man, let me be honest with you, man. I thought you'd be locked up, dead or in jail by now, man. And he said, when I saw you was still around, I said, man, something has to be tech. Protecting you. You gotta be telling the truth. So praise be the Most High, brother. Thank you for telling.
Come.
So it has to be real, man, for you to be around this long.
Come.
See? That's the beauty of success, man. See, the problem with a lot of people, the only thing that separates average people from great people, Nefertali, is consistency and discipline. Those two things. This is a problem that Barack Shah had. I had to call him out, man. Consistency and discipline. People that's not successful usually lack one or the other. Either you're not disciplined enough, and if you're not disciplined, you're not going to be consistent. If you're disciplined, that discipline has to be consistent. Because when you do it over and over and over again, whatever field of endeavor, you're going to become very good at it. So it's time to stop leasing. You know, you lease a car. You got to stop leasing greatness, and you got to own it. You got to own it, man. You see what I'm saying? They leasing great. Oh, yeah, go. When you lease a car, you can only drive it so many miles a month. Yeah. You see what I'm saying? This is what you guys are trying to do to regret. Well, I'll go right here. I'll stop. You're leasing greatness. If you didn't sign up for failure, then you better get up and get to work, man. This is what I tell you, man. Burn the midnight oil. If you didn't sign up for failure, then you better get up. And then you make it work. Like Tyler Dotton, make it work, man. You ain't got a problem. Now you have to come up with the solution. Analyze the problem, come up with a solution. You got to play the hand that you was dealt. No one's going to come and give you a different hand, man. It's called life. Most difficult. Some of y'all hear people play that stupid aphorism. Checkers, not chess. Man, get the hell away from me with that, man. This game is called life. It's way bigger than a damn chess game. You understand what I'm saying? And you got to play the hand with that. You was dealt. But here's the thing. If you off yourself, then you lose at life because you checked out. You got to keep playing. Because when they keep dealing the cards, Nefertali, you're going to get a new hand, right?
Oh, yeah.
You get a new hand. So this is what life is, man. You got to keep playing until your hand improves. Got to play the hand that you was dealt, man. If it's not with your wife, you keep playing the game called wife until that hand changes. Because it will change.
Gone.
So you got to rise, King. And change it. You have to overcome, you have to advance, and you have to push forward. We call it in the hood, we call it grind. Well, it's grind season. It's time to grind, man. You gotta allow your grind, all of the talk and all that's good, but allow your grind to speak for you. But before this becomes your reality, you must constantly nurture it with sweat, blood, even, and tears. Pushing through whatever, man. See, greatness, success, and victory, it comes directly off the assembly line of hard work. Anyone that's great, man, that comes off the assembly line of hard work. Struggle. You want to eat? I can't figure it out. Let me go John and call the car. Nope. It's in the book. I'll go back and read it again. Comes off the assembly line of hard work, consistency, and a driven work ethic. Average, to me, that's funny. See, average, mediocrity, that should never be an option, man. That should never be an option for one who wants to live to their highest capacity. If you accept average, you just accept the failure, man. You like everyone else. What makes you so distinctive? You're not. You're average. Warriors and champions and winners. We don't take days off. It's the time that when you sleep. Let me worry about that. I'm still existing, am I? I'm living. You're existing. Let me worry about that. You understand what I'm talking about, huh?
Real.
That's where you sleep. Can't take no days off, huh? Why? Because the competition is so vast. Taking a day off could determine victory or loss. You see? Those with a warrior mentality, man, those with a winning mentality, You must go all out every day. Or you're never going to be successful, man. I hate to bust your Bible, your bubble, but that's what it requires. You got to be driven with consistency and hard work. That's your membership fee. Now you got, you join a club, a membership fee, right? Well, your membership fee for being successful is consistency, hard work, discipline. That's your membership fee that literally filters the weak and the feeble from the strong and the driven. Because the weak, they're gonna fall out. When it becomes overly challenging, they give up, they fall out. The respect and the credibility required for this warrior mentality, man, for a champion mindset, for higher achievers, it is so costly that only those rich, watch this, right? Watch this, man. Only those rich with the wealth called struggle can afford it. I got rich in this wealth called struggle, Nefertali. I was homeless, man. You broke. Nigga, all right, this just made me rich, man. That's the best damn thing that ever happened to me, man. It's the best thing that ever happened to me. Because I learned. I never learned something for something that I already knew, man. I said, that's Barack Shaw, man. Do you want it bad enough? Do you want it bad enough? If so, you better get up and get after it. You want to be successful? You want to be great? You want to be a champion? I don't care what field of endeavor it is, man. I don't care what you want to be, what you want to do. You got to only have one goal. And that's aspired to be great. You can't, this has to be chiseled with a hammer of determination, not a hammer of excuses. You gotta continue this, man, with maximum effort. See, we some of us, we'll go to a certain point, man, but then we wanna give up. We become complacent. But this struggle, this difficulty, this challenge has to become your reality, man. It has to be a relentless pressure that allows you, man, the man, the woman that wants to be successful, the one with the warrior mentality, mindset, to overcome any talent deficiencies, right? Because some people are gonna be more talented than you. You know how you overcome that talent deficiency? Discipline and consistency. That's it, man.
All with these talent.
Come.
Facts.
You'll overcome that. So if you want to be a legend, because everybody want to be famous. This is why people on social media, all over social media, right? Everybody want to be famous. Everybody want to be a legend, right? You must refuse to give anything less than 100%. That's what's required. If you're not doing that, get out of the way, man. I'm trying to be great. That's the only level of effort. If you want to be a legend, that's the only level of effort that a legend knows is given his all or her all to be great. If you're not ready to do that, man, forget about it. Average mediocrity, again, I reiterate, awards that should be like foreign. It should be like a foreign, unspoken language. That the warrior mindset, the successful man, that the champion does not understand. Oh, you speaking loser. I can't talk to you. I had to talk Barack Shaw that a couple times. He's starting going to that nigga. I say, yo, hold on. Yo, you speaking loser. I can't talk to you right now. I'll hit you later. He said, well, what you talking about? I say, yo, you speaking loser. You're speaking a lot of negativity, man. You're speaking this stuff into existence. I can't allow you to put this spirit on me right now. Get your mind right, kid. I don't speak loser, man. I was like, yo, my man, you got to start looking at this from a positive perspective. You're concentrating on the negativity. Someone get the book of Proverbs 23, verse 7. Watch this. Well, you speaking this stuff into existence, man. Your mind's going to go there. You're going to start to act this out. You're placing limitations on the Most High. Someone give me the book of Genesis 1 and 26. After that, Proverbs. Go ahead. Read what you got, King.
The book of Proverbs, chapter 23, verse 7. For as he thinketh in his heart, so is he.
So you can't speak loser to me. I don't want to be around that, man. You're a loser. That's what you're speaking at. Speak greatness, man. Speak life. That fatality speaking life into the man. I can feel the man lighting up through the phone, man. I said, go ahead, Brother Nefertali. Go ahead, Brother Nefertali. Praise be to the Most High. You're speaking life into him, man. Lit him up. You can hear the joy coming through the brother through the phone, man. So when you speak loser, then you place a limitation on your who. Someone give me the book of Genesis 1 and 26. Watch this. Can't put no limitations on Yahuwah.
Bring it out.
Book of Genesis, better shift. Chapter 1, verse 26. The Supreme Elohim said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth.
Y'all hear that? Man is made in the image of Yahuwah, that you call God. Why are you placing a limitation on that, man? So if you're made in his image and likeness, why are you broke? Can you imagine Most High going off of himself, man? Because someone trying to throw a challenge at him? Man, he was, what's to say the Most High winked at that thing, man? You're going off yourself, man. You was made in the image. Somewhere along the line, Satan got in the way, man. Start whispering. Satan's whispering in the man's ear, man.
Facts.
He didn't have enough. He didn't have enough righteousness in him to combat that. So you always gotta have enough here, and in here, to combat all of the external forces that's coming after you. Otherwise, you're gonna succumb to the attacks. That's what happened to Barak Shah. He wasn't strong enough spiritually. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, spiritual wickedness, and this is what he was battling against. Nobody touched him physically. It was the inner me, his greatest enemy. There's a war going inside in that man's head, man. That brother's head, man. Take the limitations off of Yahuwah, man.
Come. The book of Ephesians, chapter 6, verse 12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
Come. See that? That's what he was battling against. And he didn't have enough within him to combat those demons. Because let me tell you, what was on Monique was a damn demon. What was on the child support system was demons. What jumped on his daughter were demons. These demonic entities overtook that body and they came after him, man. Just like the apostles, man. When they're trying to cast those demons out, they wasn't strong enough so the demons got in them and overtook them. It's not new, man. See, those were for warriors' mentality, what Yahuwah's mindset. They hold themselves the highest standards. Well, if you was made in the image and likeness of Most High and he blew his breath of life into you, man, that means you're supposed to have God in you, man. And when you that means you got God in you, you walk like a God and you act like a God. So Psalms 82 verse 6 said, we're all the Most High's children to the Most High power. Someone give me that. Psalms 82 verse 6.
Book of Psalms, Tehillim, chapter 82, verse 6. I have said, ye are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High.
So how are you going on like a coward? You don't have the mind of the Most High. Why? Because you allowed an enemy to contaminate your mind. So then the Most High say, Your ways are not my ways. Your thoughts are not my thoughts. Mine are from below, mine are from above, but yours are from beneath. Why? Because you let the enemy control your mind. We gotta have the Most High's mind, man. Yahuwah's mind. A warrior mentality. You hold yourself to the highest standard because the mere fact, you're not just doing it for yourself. You're doing it for the glory of Yahuwah. But the scriptures say everything that you do, let it be done for the glory of Yah. You know what I'm talking about? You got to think about everything that you're doing. You think Barack Shawin and blew his brains out for the glory of the Most High? Think about that. It's rhetorical. I don't need you to answer it. Give me Colossians 3 and 17. Someone give me 1 Corinthians 10 and 31. Huh?
Come. The book of Colossians, chapter 3, verse 17.
So the 1 Corinthians, start at verse 23. Go ahead, read what you got, Doc.
Book of Colossians, chapter 3, verse 17. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of HaMashiach Yahushua, giving thanks to the Supreme Elohim, the Father, and the Father by him.
Y'all hear that? Now, do you think that this man blew his brains out for the glory of the Most High? There's your answer, man, so you can't get caught up over that. He was a good brother, man, but he made that decision. He's a good brother. But I'm not going to wear that. I'm not going to allow you to put that on me, man. Most High say, come to me when you're heavy laden. That's Satan talking, man. That's how Satan whispering in his ear. 1 Corinthians 10, man. 23.
Come on. The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 10, verse 23. All is permitted me, but not all do profit. All is permitted me, but not all build up. Let no one seek his own, but each one that of the other. You eat whatever is sold in the meat market, asking no questions because of the conscience. For the earth belongs to Yahuwah and all that fills it. And if any of the unbelievers invite you, and you wish to go, you eat whatever is set before you, asking no question on account of the conscience. And if anyone says to you, this was offered to idols, do not eat it, because of the one pointing it out to you.
Let's turn on that up. Let's go into something else, man. So the work ethic of one of a warrior's mindset, with the mind of Yahuwah Yahusha, the mindset of a champion, will carry them places. 99% of this population of the earth cannot go. This is not for everyone, man. See, what you gotta do, you must discover the most essential factors that determine success. Whichever field of endeavor, doesn't matter what you're doing. You have to put in your time, your energy, your devotion into it. You gotta grind all day, all day. Doing the right things. Because you're grinding all day doing the wrong things, it'll pull you away from your success. But not only get you nowhere, but you will end up a failure. So you must be driven to outwork the competition. There's always going to be competitors, man. But your enemy is your enemy. That's what's going to decide who's going to be the winner, man. How hard you push. You got to put 100% in towards the things that really matter. So you got to stay focused. You got to have naysayers to come around you. Oh, man, let's go hang down, man. I can't do that, man. I'm on my purpose. See, here's the thing, here's a fact, right? Most people could give their best for about 3 days, 4 days,
selected few that can sustain that for a year, 2 years, 3 years, 5 years, or a decade. I've been doing this for decades, man. Over a decade. And things worth achieving. It doesn't arrive overnight, brothers and sisters. I wish I could lie to you and tell you that, but I'm not going to do that to you. When a lot of you find out it doesn't arrive overnight, you quit. So you're a jack of many trades and you don't master none. It takes years of dedication and preparation to bring dreams into reality. Know what I told you? If you want to have a victorious business, right? You got to have a victorious business plan. See, that's not constructed out of wishing. It's constructed on a silent structure, discipline plan. And you gotta commit to hard work, labor. If you're not willing to do that, man, don't talk about being successful and don't think you're ever gonna be successful. See, the one in the arena with his hands held high, or his hand held high. This kind of victory belongs to the one that purchased it with sweat, with determination, with struggle. I'm interested, man. What you accomplish in life will be equivalent to the level that you exerted yourself. That's real. There's no dream, no goal, or ambition person who literally masters the art of being driven. If you can keep trying hard enough, you're gonna get it, man. Nobody may have told you that, but you're gonna get it, man. It's coming. But you gotta be patient. Long suffering. Success doesn't have to be complex. You gotta just decide what you want and grind at a level that's required to get it. That's it, man. You gotta tell yourself, man. I'm gonna give you a positive affirmation, man. You gotta tell yourself, my grind and driven work ethic becomes my weapons. From today forward, try and tell Barack Shark on this, man. I guess it reached him too late. From today forward, no one in my soul will ever outwork me again. My dedication, my consistency, my hard work, my sweat will water my dreams. He watering those dreams, man. Just like a farmer, man. Your dreams are in the garden of your mind, man. You gotta nourish them, you gotta water them. I will give 100%, man. Day in, day out. For as long as it takes for me to accomplish my goals. That's you gotta tell yourself, man. This building up your mental faculty. Know what I told you, David? Take one day at a time, man. Get off of that bottle, man. But ask yourself the questions. How can I increase my work ethic to a level that will ensure success? How many hours do I need to grind each day to achieve greatness? Am I willing to pay the price? For the things I... See, these are the questions I had to ask myself. This is... Yashabin was telling you about my book, The Corporation, man. Wait until this next book come out. Why am I here? I'm talking about this kind of stuff in my book. That's why it's coming off my dome like this, because I just wrote about it. I've been writing about it. Am I willing to keep the intensity day in and day out needed to be successful? You gotta ask yourself these questions, man. Then you gotta go and pray. You gotta have a daily prayer, man. You gotta go and pray. I pray today, Yahuwah will instill in me the work ethic required to be successful in life. Provoke me to be driven. Increase my endurance, my stamina, and my energies so that I can allocate all my accomplishing goals and dreams that you put in me. And your whose name I pray. Amen. You got to say little things like that too, man, when you're thinking about giving up. Because your enemy is your enemy. Oh. What did Michelangelo say? Michelangelo said, if people knew how hard I had to work to gain my mastery, it would not seem so wonderful. You see what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
A man is telling you in that statement that, listen, man, to be successful is not easy. He said he wouldn't want it if they knew the hardship he had to go through. Eric Thomas said, if you want to be great, you must pay the price. The price the average is unwilling to pay. Will Smith said, I view my life as slightly above average. So the man said he's just a little bit above average in talent. And where I excel is ridiculous, sickening work ethic. Y'all? It's that will to be driven, man. Tiger Woods. You know, flip the car over, go off, smash and eat a white woman. Yeah, that Tiger Woods. Tiger Woods said, people don't understand when I grew up. I was never the most talented. I was never the biggest. I was never the fastest. I certainly wasn't the strongest. The only thing I had was my work ethic. And that is then what got me this far. Tiger Woods said that, man. So all of you in the sounds of my voice, man. And in spite of the brother Barack Shah choosing his option, you have to decide if your dreams is worth the time, the energy, the effort that's required to make it a reality. If it is, you got to make it a commitment to yourself right now. Not tomorrow, not an hour from now, right now. You got to give 100% effort every single day. Henceforth, you set the tone for the day by establishing a morning routine. I got routines, y'all. That morning routine should consist of power and purpose. You got to take ownership, man. Take ownership for the day by getting into motion. Not just, oh, I'm going to sleep a little bit long. Don't get your behind up, man. Stay healthy, exercise regularly. Stay fit, man. In the midst of all of this, I stay healthy, I exercise. You gotta remove and eliminate all distractions from your life, man. You gotta remove all negative people from your life. And you gotta figure out the amount of time required each day to reach your goals. And every time someone doubts, every time a debtor doubts you, criticizes you, you gotta respond by increasing your number of minutes, your number of hours. You understand? That you're putting in towards your dreams, because that should just push you harder.
Yep.
Use their negative energy as fuel to grind harder. Stop making excuses. You just gotta do what it takes to get your goals that you want in life. How you be successful, man. You just gotta keep pushing forward. Critics gonna always be there, man. Most High has blessed us all, man, with certain powers and energies, man. You just gotta summon yours. You gotta summon yours to come to the surface. Someone give me the book of 1 Kings 2, verse 3. Bless this. 1 Kings 2 and 3.
Book of 1 Kings, chapter 2, verse 3. And keep the charge of Yahuwah, the Supreme Allah, to walk in his ways, to keep his statutes and his commandments and his judgments and his testimonies, as it is written in the law of Moses, that thou mayest prosper in all that thou doest and whithersoever thou turnest thyself.
So you gotta have faith, man. Faith is like the four winds, man, that blows oxygen of life into your lungs, right? For you, let's say you want to be an artist, right? But with the paintbrush of your mind, you could decide to paint success or you paint failure, which the Barack Shah choose. If you go the way alone, you see footprints in the sand. And when you fall, no one will be there to pick you up or assist you in getting back up on your feet. But if you travel the course with Yahuwah, by Yahusha, you see that? Those footprints in the sand? That's when he was back there and picked you up and carried you through those channels and times. But we got to show him that we believe in him. And we do that by obeying him. We do that by keeping his laws, statutes, and commandments. And walking how he's ordered us to walk, not doing what we want to do. So if you want to be successful, if you want to be blessed, you want to be unstoppable, you got to keep the Lord's statutes and commandments of the Most High, man. As written in the word of Moses, huh? So that you may have prosperity over all things that you do. It is written. This is Yahushua's promise to us, man. This is Yahuwah's promise to us. Give me the book of Hebrews 12 and 6. See, the one limitation that the Most High has is he damn sure can't break his own promise. So if he promised you something, it's coming, man.
Come. The book of Hebrews, chapter 12, verse 6. For whom Yahuwah loveth, he chasteneth and scourgeth every son whom he receiveth.
So why did I have the brother read that? Because I need you to understand that don't you ever assume that you're going to walk with Yahuwah and you're not going to undergo struggle, difficult, pain. You'll not be able to properly walk with Yahuwah if you attempt to follow the path of lesser resistance, Naphtali, or to follow him emotionally. Oh, why is God doing this? Can't follow the Most High like that, man. See, you must have a modicum. Damn, Tazzy, what you talking about, modicum? What kind of word is that? I don't just came up.
Come on.
The boy genius knows modicum.
A small amount.
Yeah, a small amount.
Come on.
Come on, see? So you gotta have a modicum of rules that will literally prevent you from aborting the path that leads to success. You don't need a lot, just a small amount. Most High is the greatest, man. He has no equal. There's no power equal to him, man. He's omnipotent, and you're omnipotent. The wisdom of this world is foolishness compared to the Most High, man. That's in Corinthians, man. See the naysayers and your envious family members, because a lot of them, let's face it, a lot of them are envious, man. They might construct distractions, right? They might construct a diatribe of attacks to deter you, but you can't yield to their negative behaviors or these negative people. Their lives is it the solitary, whereas the Creator has a perfect plan for you to be successful. What did he say before you was an open door? And no man could close it. Did he not say that, Nefertali? He was created in the image of Yahuwah, man. Created in the image and likeness, man. Stop placing limitations on the Most High, man. He was created in his image and likeness. You gotta believe it, man, and call it into existence. I tried to instill that into Barack Shawn, man. Doubt is the enemy of success. Talking negative, man, that's the enemy of success. Self-loathing is a dire illness that cripples you from your greatness, man. Excuses are crutches that prevent you from attaining your dreams, your goals.
Bring it out.
Challenge, man. We gotta run to the challenge. Man, I didn't even know my camera wasn't on this. Wait that. Well, this time, you guys been talking, listening to an icon. I wanted them to see my face, man. I've been talking to the spirit. My camera wasn't even on. Overheated. Huh. Well, maybe it was. Maybe it overheated. I didn't catch it. I don't know how long that icon was there, man. So you gotta believe. See, a true champion, a true warrior is driven by a warrior's mentality. Success is not gonna reach out to any of us, man. You must strive for it. It's a lonely road. I meant it's a more challenging journey. Yet it's a more rewarding one when you get there. Anyone that is truly in favor of you being successful and great, they will support you on your mission to greatness. Those that attempt to talk you out of greatness, envy, and they secretly learn to see you. They yearn to see your failure as they forward. You see? Don't allow the naysayers and negative people to define you. You must extirpate all negative people and thoughts out of your life. Do it now. You got to detach your emotions and make rational decisions to eliminate all people and things that has a negative impact in your life. Such people will drive you mentally and spiritually and thereby destroy you. Destroy what Yahuwah has actually planned for you to be there. They're not part of what Yahuwah has planned for you. They're just a small section in your life. And that chapter in your book is over. And you must move forward into new heights. They're not on your level of vibration. So will you sacrifice your goals and your dreams for someone who does not genuinely care for you, even though they claim to? Or will you align yourself with Yahuwah's divine will and eliminate these unclean spirits and dwell with people that have your best interest in mind? Your time is now. You will not have a second opportunity. All things are relevant to time. This is your time. Do it now. Come. You need to place yourself within a mental state where you can visualize where you want to be in 5 years. 1 year from now, 1 month from now, 1 minute from now. Where do you want to be? You don't have to say it, but nah, you're probably driving right now. You don't even have to say it. So you must ride with some urgency, man, for success. You got to sweat. Your preparation has to be victory. Y'all, what I told you, Justice, you need to be sweating. You need to be perspiring victory. Success is not going to come to those sitting around on the sofa watching Netflix marathons. Success comes to those that has the willpower to push beyond their perceived limitations. Right?
Come.
You got to ask yourself, Justice Raheem, I'm allowing outside forces to distract me from accomplishing my mission. Am I still talking about what I'm going to accomplish, or am I speaking my thoughts into existence and making it a reality? You gotta ask yourself that, man. Have I done the things that are necessary to align me with the path that the Most High has created me? Wow. Are you working on a job that you hate, but you do it because you need the money for survival? and you fear, without that joy, you will not be able to make it. If you are, then you're already dead. You're just existing because you're not living. Are you still in a relationship that is causing you a deluge of worrying and making you mentally and physically sick? But ask yourself, brothers, sisters, why am I still holding on to things that people that are not beneficial towards me accomplishing my goals and what my Creator has planned for me? What's more imperative? Is it for me to remain in a relationship with someone that is keeping me on a lower level, a vibration, or to detach those negative people and emotions from my life? You have to ask yourself those, man. It is the weak who's cruel, man. Gentleness can only be expected from the strong. We all need a target. If there's no target, I reiterate, then you don't have a goal to aim at. If you have no target and no goal, then you have no focus. Where there's no focus, there's no goal, there's no dream, there's no reason. You don't have a why. There's no why. What is your why? Everyone in the sounds of my voice, what is your why for being born? Why am I here? That's the name of my book. Why am I here? Can you answer that question? When I told someone I was going to name a book, why am I here? You know the idiot started laughing at me? Started laughing. I said, no, brother, that's actually the title. Why am I here? That's why I asked you the question. Why are you here? He had this extremely stupid look on his face. He couldn't answer it.
He's going to laugh at you.
Why am I here? See, unless you know this, you'll always be just average. You should never expect to be great. Barack Shah know where he was here? See, there's a land of the living, and there's a land of the dead. The bridge to this great gulf is a love. Love me fully, but leave me alone fully. Because I reiterate, both Yahuwah and High Shaitan is not done with me yet. The tempter's always out there trying to tempt you. See, we gotta wake. We have to peer into the mirror of our mind's reflection and witness that there's a war going on between the person we're striving to become and the person that society and others attempt to program us to be. The question is, which one will you be, man? Some of us are given the pressures of society. Barack Shah. We're given the pressures of society and we give into it. And then we consider that to be known what is known as adjustment. But there's a selected few. There's 1% that says, no, I will not be a clone. I will not surrender to the pressures of society. I am becoming, and I will continue to develop into me. I will not allow you to impose upon me. Justice is Raheem's voice. So from today forward, you're going to have to commit to being a better you than you were yesterday. If you went to the gym, you done 10 reps yesterday, do 11 a day. You've been studying, you read 31 pages yesterday, read 31 and a half today, 32. Making yourself a little better each day. If you want to be successful, you must find the passion. And you chase your passion. Don't chase money. Money will not bring true happiness. When you're doing your passion, it's no longer a job, man. It becomes an enjoyment. Following your passion and not a lust for money. Turn off the television. Pick up a book. Practice it. And put it to work towards accomplishing your goals. It's the best thing that I could ever tell you. Hey, you. I turn it to Nefertali Kedar and everyone else is on the floor. Hey, you.
tell you what. That's definitely needed. Definitely needed. So I mean, I pray to everyone that's you know, in the audience, on the panel, you know, whoever you lay on the message that just went forth, pick up your mantle, pick up your stake, and roll with it. It is meant for us to press and to be great, but it doesn't come without sacrifice. Must be willing. We're built for this thing. And I'm in full agreement. If I'm going out fighting.
Come on.
To the very last breath, to full exhaustion, pushing till I literally cannot physically push anymore. I ain't going back. I don't care what anybody say. I don't care how many losses, you know, that come, or folks that be trying to come, it is not happening. It's too much to look forward to. Way too much. Kahan has shown us way too much. I ain't no giving up. Got too much fight. Got too much fighting. So, man, for everybody else, does the same thing, man. Does the same thing. Folks falling all over the place. It does not have to be. If we will it not to be.
Come.
Come. I think people really need to take heed to the concept and the fact that thoughts are things, man. And things are thoughts. So everything that we touch, everything that we see in the flesh was once a thought that was harbored with love, with a greater purpose in mind. That chair you're sitting on was once a thought that was manifested through hard work, sweat, and tears. And in the same way, on the contrary, if you harbor a toxic thought, you know, those things will bring your demise. And those toxic thoughts are usually harbored in your subconscious mind. Because we know that, you know, Yahuwah is conscious, you know, he is always conscious, you know, and that he is enlightenment. So when we are conscious, we are with him, we are one with him, we do his will, not that of our own. But when we are in our subconscious mind and we're harboring these toxic ideas and thoughts, as I say, Tim, you know, causing tremble amongst the earth, like it says in Isaiah, I believe, chapter 14. You know, when he fell down, he caused the earth to tremble, and he, you know, he tried to rise himself up to the heavens. But, you know, he can't be like Yahuwah, man. He can only appear to be like Yahuwah. Just like your subconscious mind makes you think certain things about yourself, makes you think lowly of yourself, it can only appear like the truth, only if you give it power, you know. But that's your lower state of mind. You can't take heed to that, because that's how Satan working, man. The scriptures tell us that the battle's against not flesh and blood, but principalities, you know, and it's how Satan is instilling these principalities in our subconscious mind through what we consume, through you know, who he does his, you know, his evil work with. You know, you gotta remain set apart and remain conscious of all these things. Because Yahuwah ordained us from the beginning, when he created us in his image from the beginning.
Come. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with Yah. The Creator created man after his image and after his own likeness. Like the Kahan said, we have the Most High in us. It ain't nothing we can't accomplish. Ain't nothing we can't achieve. All we gotta do is put forth that effort just to get to it. How Rocky said, I don't hear no bell. I didn't hear no bell.
Come on.
It's time to go in. I mean, go all the way in. Those spirits and them demons took one of our strong soldiers, copped out. Like the Kahan said, we all go through some kind of hardships. We all go through torment every single day over here in the wilderness of a Mexican. You already know what it is. You know what I'm saying? We go against adversity every day. You think brothers got their name, got our best interests at heart? You know what I'm saying? You don't know what's going on. All you know that you just gotta keep striving, keep moving, keep getting it. Every day going in, knowing that we great. Brother told me at the Just Over Broke, he said, brother, can you send me some information who you be listening to? Because I want to know where your energy come from. I said, true disciples of Christ. Check on it. I'm going to send you the link. You probably in the background listening now. Y'all out there, peace and blessings be upon you. Thank you for showing up. My BM, I pray you listening. For real. I'm nothing but a humble servant. We can do this thing together. No issues. No. Great communication. You and I versing together, bringing forth a glorious overstanding. Period. You made your choice. That's your choice. You got to deal with that in the Most High. But when it comes to our offspring, we just going to rise together and make sure we bring nothing but peace, love, joy, and pure love to our offsprings and those around us, period. We not capping out. I'm not capping out. None of me and my brothers not capping out. Because we got this. Humble servants.
So right. Okay, Jason Wesley, your device is not connected. You might want to go out and come back in. It's a lot. Oh, go ahead.
Come. We got the blueprint. We got a Kahan. We got a priest. We got a star seed that has laid out the blueprint. Laid out the blueprint upon blueprint. We got a raw catalyst. Live as a man. We not pheasants. We royalty, period. And the system know who we are, know how raw we are. That's why we go through so much adversity, because we the truth. We are the walking truth. Richly melanated kings and queens, period. Pardon me, Slocket, princesses, you know what I'm saying? And kings, period. That's just the reign supreme, period. We are pure royalty. We just gotta live it. I be telling my offspring, and she brings so much joy when I be giving her that raw truth, and she be like, Khan. I be like, oh, praises, dude, my princess be giving it back to me. Shalom, my king, Khan. I be like, okay, oh, praises, dude. Khan. You know, I be lit up, and she catch me off guard with it, too. I be like, you understand, you overstand, baby. She be like, Khan. I be like, oh, praises, dude. Yeah, how I love her. Yeah. She give it to me. I be like, okay. Oh, praises, dude. That ain't nothing but a blessing from the Most High. Yeah, you know. So, you already know, man. We here, man. With that, I yield.
On West, go ahead.
Just in here, man, standing as an energy provider, man. I got so many Akam on my side, man, and we seem so strong. But we also have a little weakness in us as well. So I'm just standing in, man, and we all got to do better. And I'm talking to myself, so don't nobody feel offended about this. Because Barack was a stand-up dude. And I know we all saying like, hey, man, I wish you would have called me. I wish you would have texted me. And then we said, well, we should have called. So we should contact and speak with each other. I know we all from different cities and states. And some of us hang together, some of us don't. But I love y'all, man, like we came out the same mama and popped out the same daddy. I'm just going to try to stand up and be better, man. That's a loose chain that's not hurting no more, but he was a strong chain. I'm just trying to keep stepping with him. Because I'm just jumping in and bouncing in like jump rope, just trying to keep it steady. But this is a position and slot that he was in. And he was concrete with it. So I'm just trying to be a little stronger, man, and just catch some energy from y'all, man, and just be stronger because we all going through it. We all going through this nonsense. We all trying to put these documents together. We all trying to get our sons back and daughters back and going through this bullshit nonsense. And they want to fight us back and tag team with the side, tag team with the ops. They want to put restraining orders on you. And when they was jumping up and down on that tallywhacker many years ago, however many years ago where we was with our exes, I don't think that we'll ever see them change the way they have. Some of us may have even had conversations with them, like if we may have broke up, or if a day comes, if a rainy day comes where you want to go your way and I go my separate way. Some of us may have had conversations. And they still drop the ball and still don't care and still choose to do what they do. And I know it's painful, man, and I just try to tell myself on a day-to-day basis that some people that ain't seen their kids in months, some people that ain't seen their kids in a year or so. We got some in our back pocket that we know in our phone ain't seen their kids in years. And we break down over a few months because I know I've been breaking down. And I got to tell myself, Jay, stand up, stop being a coochie. You got partners I ain't seen their kids in years. You got partners with stories that say, hey, man, my chick moved out of state. She gone. I ain't seen them in years. So it's just horror stories. It's war stories. And I just hate to have it, man, because a lot of y'all ox, we done called each other's phone and jumped on with Kahan, you know, speaking and just delegating and hop on a recorded line, and just to hear y'all voice, man, just bring me so much joy. And Brother Barack was one of those dudes. Knew a guy, and he calling with Kahan, with Kadar on the left side and Barack on the other side. JJ, what's good, young brother? You're going to be able to do this? You're going to be able to do that? And to know for a few seconds, for a few minutes, it just got unbearable. Yeah, we've been dealing with it for years. Yeah, we've been dealing with depression for years. Yeah, we come from the block. Yeah, we got a checkered background, a checkered past. We play checkers. Yeah, the back look like Connect Four. We still trying to connect them. But the other side cheating us in the game. But my boy Marty Mar hurt me. But this one, I didn't see it coming. We got our older peeps that have situations where they get older, they get in pain, and they don't want to go through the agony anymore. So you could kind of understand and put those together where you don't want to see your elders in pain. But this one, and this is what we all going through. There's a few of us, I say maybe 3 to 4 or 5 of us, maybe that's on this call right now. I know I'm number one, if everybody didn't want to know. We got my number daughter up in there.
Number two.
And the lies that they go through. Y'all should have, if y'all would have seen the court situation that happened on December 27th last year, that she had my daughter, the way she made her act in front of the judge, y'all would have fell out laughing. Y'all would have thought this was an episode of Jerry Springer. The judge had to take off his robe and come out to the hallway to see why Lerman going back and forth. What's all the commotion? What's going on? And he eventually honored the habeas corpus, and then he told, hey, man, counsel, you need to have your... need to have your client leave, because he could see through the bullshit. Most High be beautiful to this day. It was a brother. It was a judge, bro. You don't get that a whole lot. It was a brother. It looked like he could have been old enough to be my pawpaw. And he told the other side of the council, because they were doing a counter petition against me because I wanted more time. And they counter petitioned to do what they do. Let me counter petition to say D-R-U-G-S, to say the happy plan. Let me go through that process. And I did my little thing and did what I needed to do. But I was clean during the whole time. I still wanted to put in my paperwork just to see if I could stand. Conditional acceptance, whatever you need to do, however you need to do it. And eventually the drug test went clean. Ain't nothing dirty over here. because I had been preparing for it. I kind of felt it, you know, once you miss a couple of visitations and nobody calls and nobody answering and they start saying this and saying that, you're like, oh man, I'm probably finna get ready to jump off the top rope. I can feel it. I can see the way you acting. We finna do this again? We finna go through this court routine again? Some of our was getting older, man. They not in elementary anymore. They going through middle school and high school. We finna be acting like this until they in their teens and their 20s?
So lock your arc. I mean, Elder David, David, you can mute out for a second. Let the brother
complete
his speech.
So, man, I'm just a quiet dude, man. I just like to sit back and relax and listen to y'all and sponge it up, because I you know, you lose that faith when you're coming out of the Bible and coming from those old churches where they don't want to usually teach you anything, or they can only give you certain scriptures about certain situations on how they're governed to do so. So I sit back a lot and just listen to y'all, man, and just soak it in. And I'm just trying to be stronger, man, because it's a lot going out here. So I'm not going to hold the flow too much longer, man. I appreciate y'all letting me cry on your shoulder. And I'm going to digress and lay on back, man, and just stand post like we supposed to and let y'all take it, man. But appreciate you coming for allowing me to speak. Appreciate you, Kadar, and the rest of my crew.
Digger, if you keep talking, I'm going to kick you off of here, man. You're being very rude, man. If you're intoxicated, this is not the time to be on it.
So young man, how old are you?
I just hate to see the pain got to him that way. Okay. Hate them demons jumped up that way and made you want to hurt yourself. We got them years. We got years coming, man. We gonna get there. We can't go out like that, man. They counting on us. There's only so much they can do with the tutoring that they getting from their mom on the other side. Sometimes they don't want to let them speak on the phone. They don't want to see you. They want to give them stories to fabricate. But they depending on us, man, to be there in the future. So you just got to stay focused and pray. Cry, man. Wipe your tears. You ain't the only one crying. I promise you, it's tears dropping in Texas,
that's,
man.
That's right, Con. That's right. He got you, didn't he?
Guys, you're drunk, man. I don't feel like listening to it.
Con. Yeah, no, keep that spirit out of here, man.
Yeah, he needs his ass whipped.
Facts.
I was about to say something that I don't want to say, man.
Really?
Yeah. He needs his ass whipped, man. This guy, I mean, he can't even stay damn sober in situations like this. That guy's an alcoholic.
That's how he copes, man.
Go ahead, JD.
Well, just wanted to say my condolences to everybody, and you know, just terrible news. And you know, even though we butted heads, you know, I could always tell the guy had a strong heart, you know, he had a very good heart. I could feel it. You could feel it through what he spoke, you know. It's a shame, man. It's a big shame.
Yeah, I don't think anyone realized that he was you know, in such a depressive state, because I definitely didn't. So I guess some people hide behind a facade, you know, they paint a certain thing, but really inside, you know, they have a hard shell externally, but internally they're pretty soft, you know. Just crumbled under the pressure.
I mean, just know. I mean, I'm sure he knows that he had good friends. You guys were his pals, and you know, you included him, and he was at your events and stuff like that. You know, just know that you guys were there for him. You know, it's just sad. It's just the waste, man. It's a waste.
Yeah, but right there, man. I don't know.
I was kind of like beating myself up for a little bit, because once the during the time of the Passover, the brother reached out to me, and I was telling myself I'm gonna reach out to the brother every day. Since that day, I just fell off, got so succumbed with that just over broke. coming home just resting for real. I felt kind of responsible, like maybe the brother wouldn't have done that if I would have called, you know what I mean? Somebody told me, you know what I mean, don't do that to yourself, you know what I'm saying? The more, like, it's like the Quran said, the most I ordained for that to happen the way it went down, for real.
Come on. None of us were meant to intervene with that, man. None of us.
Yeah, he had told me he'd been calling Yasha Bean, but Yasha Bean didn't return his call, man. You know, people usually carry out certain actions prior to death, you know, whether they're doing it subconsciously or whatever. But I've noticed that trend that people have a tendency to do certain things, man, even if they're not conscious of it, before they're going to, you know, just pass on into a spiritual realm. And I'm starting to, like, notice this trend, man, like the text messages that God's been reading me that he sent, you know?
Come. It's like they reaching out for help. Mm-hmm. Or some type of intervening they want us to do with something.
Hey, Shalom, fam. Shabbat Shalom to all my brothers and my sisters that's listening. I just got one thing to say. I never thought in a million years Rockshaw do that, man. I'm just looking at it from me walking on this path for a long time. Well, I ain't gonna say a long time, but I say 6+ years or whatnot. Man, I ain't never seen a brother go so down and out where he wanna, you know what I mean, hurt himself or murk himself. And I'm just thinking about how whenever I tend to this platform, I see new brothers pop up like Benaya, Yasha Bean, you know what I'm saying? Especially Will, man. Like, I ain't never seen that brother ain't never been weak, you know what I'm saying? He, whatever he went through, he just kept going. No matter how much I keep chastised, he kept going. No matter what Will went through, he kept going. And just for Barack Shaw, man, just, it's sad, man, because I never thought he'd do that, man.
Khan, he sent me a text message. I don't know what it was about. He said he wanted to help me with something.
It was about taking some sort of herbs or whatever.
No, he said he wanted to help me with something.
I'm not what he's talking about right there, man.
Yeah, so I spoke to him on the 5th, on the 8th, and the 11th. You know, I called him. Before that, I think he called me, like, he only called me like once before that. But we did talk about those herbs, because he was, you know, inquiring about possibly growing his hair back and you know, different things like that. So we had that call, you know, for me to see what kind of habits, you know, that he's into, and you know, smoking and drinking and stuff, because that'll impede, or, you know, eating, you know, certain type of stuff. So it seemed like he took hold of it. But when he texted me on the 18th was something about he wanted to help me with something about get me out of a situation. I'm not exactly sure what he was referring to, but I figured he just might have sent that to the wrong person. You know, that happens. But outside of that, he's always been encouraging. You know, he encourages everybody. Always instilling some form of hope and belief.
Because he hated others, but himself he could not see.
Come on.
Yeah. that right there, man. You know, I can't linger on the thought too much because it just, my mind just thought, like, you know, what was this brother thinking, man? Like, you off yourself, man, in such a dramatic way.
Facts.
You know, before he shot himself, he slid, he cut his wrist first. This is extremely dramatic, man. That's really dramatic. Seth, what's going on, huh? Canary, what's going on? Oh, you said he fell out. David, come over here, Trump, man. God can't even show enough respect to come to the call sober, man.